This is the only digital research channel in India producing the documentary ethnographic films on the endangered human populations and ethnic cultures of India. So subscribe this channel to know more about the endangered human population and ethnic cultures of India on every weekend.
The Bondo is one of the primitive tribal group inhabiting in the Orissa state. They identify themselves the Rimo, which means the man. This Austroasiatic Mundari language speaking tribal group lives in hilly and mountainous region located in the northwest of the Manchankund River. The Bondo habitat is easily approachable through a 14 kilometers long road constructed by the government in order to connect the Bondo highlands with Kairaput block headquarters located in Kairaput. The Bondo villages are situated at the height of 3000 feet. It is covered with a thick vegetation of the subtropic and semi-evergreen type. The climate of the habitat is characterized by pleasant summer, cold winter and heavy rains during monsoon.
Based on the geographical location, economy and cultural differences, we can classify the Bondo into two categories. One is hill Bondo, another one is plain Bondo. The hill Bondos are living in the midst of the Bondo hills, which is having rich flora and fauna. A Bondo house is always rectangular or square in size, and the roof is covered with a typical jungle grass locally called as pirhi or dub pirhi. Leaves of diptyline tree may be substituted for the grass. Bamboos and strong logs needed for the house are obtained from the forest. A Bondo hut consists of one or two rooms. The walls are made of mud. Here you can observe the walls are made with the mud and with the natural colors they have painted. Indigenous colors they will be using for painting.
The Bondo are generally semi-clothed. The women always tonsured their heads and wear thick silver neck bands. The Bondo attire is explained in a legend relating to the Ramayana. According to it, some Bondo women chanced upon Sita, who was bathing at a pond in the Bondo hills, and seeing her naked, they sniggered. Enraged, Sita cursed them to a life where they would be condemned to remaining naked and having their heads shaven. When the Bondo women pleaded forgiveness, Sita gave them a piece of cloth she tore off her sari. This explains, according to the legend, why Bondo women have shorn heads and wear only a ringa, a length of cloth that covers the waist. Their tonsures are covered in strings of colorful beads. Bondo women also wear metal rings that cover their necks and bangles on their arms. Bondo women have their heads shaved and adorned with two types of headbands called turuba and jobeda. The turuba is made of grass and the lobeda made of beads. Worn together, the turuba secures the lobeda by preventing the beaded headband from slipping off the woman's head. The Bondo women wear metal bands adorning their necks, which are called kangla and are made from aluminium. Including the bands around their neck, necklaces made of beads are also worn. These are called mali. Due to the cluster surrounding their ringa cloth, which covers the waist down, the kangla and mali act as a sort of clothing for the upper body of the woman. Both men and women of the tribe wear earrings called limbi, made of brass, and rings on their fingers called oti, made of aluminium.
Among the Bondo, the family is mostly nuclear, consisting of married couple and their dependent offsprings. Joint or extended families are very rare.
Their problems and issues.
Among the Bondo, the residence after the marriage is patrilocal and neolocal.
We are going to have a discussion.
The newlywed couple live in the same village where the husband parental kins live. This means that a woman, consequent upon her marriage, breaks all ties with her family of orientation and gets admitted to the kula, that is clan, of her husband's automatically. The patrilocal residence pattern helps a Bondo man to keep intimate relationship with his parental kins and the community members of the village, which promotes in strengthening of the group solidarity. The Bondo society is organized based on the principles of unilineal descent, which emphasizes the father's side of the family. The family is patrilineal, in which the members receive their identity through descent reckoned in the father's line. It is traced from the father's to son, son through male line. To a Bonda, patrilineal kinship members is a social hereditary achieved by birth only and not through addition or ordinarily. By virtue of his birth in a particular family, a man becomes the biological as well as jural descendant. Under the patrilineal descent system, a Bondo male inherits his name, property, liability, family secrets and social status from his parents. The Bondo welcomes a birth of a child. They think that is a God's given gift. After the birth, in the seventh day, they perform the naming ceremony.
After 7 days, they will give the naming ceremony. So what are the names they will be keeping? Somwar, Paidavan, what is the name?
Somwar, Janmahale, Kona Nanducha?
Sombari.
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 Zioila Sombari.
Mangalwar?
Mangalwar.
Mangalwar. Budhwar ko?
Budhar.
Budha. Budha.
Guruwar?
Guruwar. Guru.
Shukrawar?
Shukru. Guru.
Shanivar?
Sanya.
Sanya. Adivar?
Sunday. Rabbar dina Janmahale?
Adi.
Adi. Adi. So this is the week. What are the days they will be giving birth? On that day, name they will be keeping for the children. Okay,
then
the Mundan ceremony is called as Arbo, which is performed after the 15th day of birth. So by this is performed in the house itself by the parents. The parents clean shave the head of the child, newborn child.
The marriage rules of the Bonda are very elaborate and framed on the basis of three sets of relationships, that is the relationship of a man with his village community, the relationship with his soru boy, and the relationship with his clan, that is kura members.
They marry the people within the village. They had to go for outside the marriage. This is a very interesting one. As though here we can observe, as though they have the six clans. The six clans people, they cannot marry among themselves within the village. They had to go for other village, and also the same clan also they can marry. For example, Salan is the clan here. The same Salan clan people in another village they can marry. That is the unique features of this tribe. Among all the six clans, Shisha clan claims the higher status because they officiates as a priestly caste. All the performance of the rituals and pujas, they will be performing the Shisha clan. Arranged marriage.
Arranged marriage.
Or marriage by negotiation is called Kilompari.
Kilompari.
Yeah. Next one.
Marriage by service. Mane, tumko suppose gote jhiyo
is ghar.
Ghar joi.
Ghar joi. Kya bolta hai?
Ghar joi.
Ghar joi. Ghar joi. Marriage by service.
Ghar joi ka.
Udula dunga. Dunga. Udula dunga marriage kiya to? Marriage by he has done marriage by elopement. That is Udula Dunga.
Udula Dunga.
Udula Dunga marriage he has done.
Udula Dunga. Udula Dunga.
How would this marriage by capture?
Marriage by capture is called Gudu. Gubai. Gudo.
Runga.
Runga. Marriage by capture is called. They have the bride price system exist among them. It is called as Guinea.
The main features of the marriage by capture is by forceful capture of a bride, followed by her and her parents' approval and payment of bride price. The capture is usually a mere pretense for a Bondo girl, cannot or easily be married against her will, and even if taken by force to captures villages, she will run away at the first opportunity unless she likes him and he has her consent. However, marriage by capture must be followed by the payment of usual bride price.
It is interesting to note that the marriage by negotiations also have to face. Is a really compared to she is a little tired because of
sometimes in the marriage by capture type of marriage, if attempts are made to marry forcibly an unwilling girl, the situation may lead to quarrel and conflict between the two concerned families, taking a violent shape, even resulting in the murder of many persons from either side. After the acceptance of the both the parents, they will pay the bride price. Then the girl is got married with the bridegroom. The village priest Sisi performs the marriage ritual, which is very simple function. In the house they will keep, and the Sisi performs by keeping betel leaves and nuts in the hands of the both boy and the girl, and the marriage is marked with the marking of a tilak on the forehead of the bride and bridegroom. Here you can observe, generally among the Bondo tribe, the boy's age is compared to less than the girl's age. Because of economic persuasions, they generally go for the elder girls to take care of the economic activities of their household.
Thank you very much. Thank you, bhai. Thank you. Thank you very much. A big house.
In every Bondo village, we have a girls' dormitory house, which is called as Silali Dingo, which exists in the middle of the village or next to the temple of the village. This is the place where during nights they will have a fire, sing songs, learn dancing, and also learn about the folklores and folk tales about their community.
For the doors and also rituals and festivals, which are important for their way of life. Now we find out some of the festivals which they are performing throughout the year, and the importance associated with the nature also reflects in their festivals. Now let us hear what are the festivals and its importance.
In the month of January, this Bonda people, they will celebrate the Pusarke Parv. This is after the grain comes to the house, they giving thanks to God. In the month of February, they will celebrate the another festival, that is Susu festival. And another festival, that is month of April, there is Ghiyai. Its name in Chaita, we can say in Chaita Parva, for eating purpose of mango, jackfruits, and eating our tendu fruits, etc. In the month of August, they will worship another festival, that is Purep. This and another festival they will worship the festival, that's Dasahara, is in this Bonda name, that is Kumbade.
We can see the Podu lands. We can observe the Podu lands on the top of the hill, where they have taken away the cut down the trees and going for the multiple different crops over the hills. In there you can see the very clearly the shifting cultivation they are doing with the mixed crops. Jowar, maize, and different crops they will be making. And the ground level, they are making the paddy fields. You can see small, small patches they have made. They are growing the paddy. You can see here. From the foothill of the hills, we have the paddy fields. And some of them have the pulses also grown here. On the castor seeds.
Paddy. Here we can observe the Bondo indigenous paddy they are growing in the small patches of wetlands. Here, the paddy is grown more than 5 feet height with the biofertilizers they are using, with their own manure without any pesticides. This is indigenous paddy which is grown in this region. It is necessary that this paddy fields to be promoted and the Bondo should be helped to preserve these rich paddy fields and also the seeds of this paddy. Here you can observe the paddy is grown with the stream water which is coming in the field itself, and they will be growing these yearly once when the water resources are available. It is a rich cultural heritage of Bondo people. Bondo economy is very simple. They used to sell their minor forest produce and agricultural produce in the weekly shanties. Here you can observe the nuts which has been collected from the forest. They are selling in the market. See, here it is very tasty nuts collected from the forest and selling it for 5 rupees each cup. That is the measurement which you observe here. This is the measurement which is sold for 5 rupees. Here we have medicinal roots which is observing here, which will be used for when the hand is broken, it will be used as a paste and applied to the broken place, it will be cured. That is one of the indigenous medicinal plant. Here we can observe the papaya, which will cost about 5 rupees. This is the fruit which is available only in this region of Malkangiri. It is sold for 10 rupees. The papaya, the tomato, and different kind of minor forest produce they will bring into the shandy, they will sell. Here you can observe the bananas, the wild variety bananas which are really very tasty. She is selling all these bananas for 10 rupees. The minor forest produce will be sold by women only. Men won't participate in the economy. They will be doing agriculture and also minor forest produce, but generally the women participates in selling these produce. It is one of the important one which you can observe here. Most of the economy is through barter system, and you can see here this is the bamboo shoots which they brought for selling. It is one of the important food for the many of the Bondo people living in the Bondo hills. So these bamboo shoots, they will boil it and they will eat it. It is really a staple food for many of them. The nuts are exchanged with the rice. See here, she is giving a cup of rice she has given, and it is exchanged with the rice. The plain people always exchange their produce with the Bondo as a barter system. Resin is one of the important minor forest produce collected by Bondo people and sell it in the weekly shandies. Here you can observe the resin collected by a Bondo lady and selling it in the market. After selling, generally they will go for purchasing of the salt which is important for them. Here you can see the salt packets which they will be purchasing. And another important one, tasting of the sweets and savories, different kind of dishes of the plain people on the occasion. After selling their minor forest produce, generally they will go for purchase of the mahua flowers. This is the mahua flowers to which they will be preparing Bondo the liquor. See here, they are taking the mahua flowers, and also many of them are purchasing the salt, spices. They will be purchasing from the shandy. Here you can see the dry fish. They enjoy with the dry fish. Here different kind of dry fish is available in the market. They will sell the produce, and the Bondo purchases this type of fish. It each one cost about 10 rupees. Different kind of dry fish they will be purchasing from the market. Apart from the fish, you can see here different kind of spices, turmeric, dhania, all type of spices also they will purchase in the weekly market. And different type of costumes, you can see here the bindis, the kumkum, the chains, the beads are also purchased by the Bondo from the shandy. Another one important one which you can see here, the mud pots. Still they are using the mud pots. They will purchase in the shandy the mud pots, which will be used for not only for keeping their storage purpose, but also for water, for cooking purposes, and prepare their mahua liquor. That is a very important one. See here, she is bargaining. And also now presently she is purchasing the plastic mat. Is a dried fish, indigenously dried by the Didai and Garba people, tribal people, which will be sold in the market. This is the freshwater fish. Malnutrition is quite common among the Bondo people. Both men and women suffer with malnutrition. Maternal mortality and infant mortality rate is very high. This is mainly due to the neglect of healthcare practices. Most of them are anemic. You can observe here, both mother and child are anemic. And there is no nutritional substitute for them. As though ICDS is working here, it is only for namesake. See here, she is a pregnant woman.
So most of the
and
women,
she is not able to get 2 meal a day,
nutritional problem.
And totally she is depending on the forest produce. She doesn't have the agriculture land also.
They are not taking. There should be
most of the pregnant women are anemic. From the inception of pregnancy to its termination, no specific nutritional diet was consumed by the woman. The consumption of iron, calcium and vitamins during pregnancy is totally nil. The habit of consumption of liquor during pregnancy was found to be common among the women. Even men, you can observe here, many also malnourished. They are not able to get proper food. Only 10% of the men are healthy. The rest of them are suffering with anemia. Here you can see, he is the priest of the village. He himself is anemic. Many of them are not able to get their sufficient nutritional food.
They doesn't have a nutritional food. They are very weak. That is the important one which you can observe among this Bondo population. We can find most often the malaria is attacking. Many of them are suffering. Yesterday also I have shown you. It is mainly because they are living with the domesticated animals. Here we can see the pig pen. The pigs are living here. This is the pig pen, and this is the, observe here, goat shed. And you can come here, you can see here, this is the cow shed. This is the cow shed.
Pigs, living with the cows, pigs and goats is one of the major reasons for spreading the malaria among the Bondo people. If they can able to maintain the distance of these domesticated animals, there won't be any problem for them. The storage place of cow dung and living with the domesticated animals is the main reason they are getting the malaria fever. Many of the ailments and diseases are cured by the Disari, who works as a medicine man for the village. Here you can see the Disari, who not only cures the diseases and infections, but also he fixes the ritual dates and festival dates. So he officiates as a priest for the entire village. Now we are going to have one of the performance of the curing of the fever, how he is going to cure the fever?
Now the author recites of the mantra, he has kept the egg and rice on the head of the child, you can see here. Now he is giving the rice. Rice is thrown in four directions. So now he has broken the egg. Now he has broken the egg and he has placed the egg on the egg. Has broken the egg and egg is placed as a bindi, that rice with a mixture with the egg yolk. Egg yolk, it has given as a bindi for both mother and female. He has taken by this and the egg is taken out. The egg shell is kept by, and that rice is also put on this egg. And now he is sprinkling water on the four directions, on the children, on the child and the mother. So this is the one of the important one, how they will be treating the mother here. You come here, we can show you the water resources.
Getting the village, sir. Okay. And the messenger is Naik.
Naik.
And another one is Salan. He will help them to the... he will support them. To
support
both
them,
of them.
Making assembly,
yeah,
and meeting.
Yeah, assembly, everything.
Okay. What are the cases generally they will be doing in this panchayat?
ऐसी किमती किसी कौन कौन समस्या हैले सब नाइक आउ चला ना पुजारी मेंबर एमन मिसिकरी को कु समस्या को तमे गां भितरे समाधान करजो
समाधान करवा पे लेके सर ए जो शिक्षा गोरेती रे हां तपरे नाइक मेंबर तपरे गुल गांवर भितरे नाइक बुझाइबो हां फरबो आसी गला किमती कर लेबो ना ए मास रे करबा हां ए मास रे न करले तो हमकु जंगल रे नाइक जंगल रे फाड़ रे जीवा पे हम भल जीवा पे असुविधा कि नहीं बोले बाघ भालू थे भितर फाड़ रहे से लोक गले कि जो गाय गोरु मन को बोले झूठा मिसा ए कर देबो सेटा पर जाई परबो नहीं से पूजा सीडा लेका नहीं पुजारी को धरले हबो किंदि धरले नहीं पूजा सीडा देबा कुकुड़ा गुटे करपा को थिबो तांको पाकर जाई करी कुकुड़ा माई करी से सोमवार दिन के मंगलवार के बुधवार दिन पूजा हेबे सेटा कुकुड़ा बाहर करी ना आउरी साउलो बोले मोर सकनी गुटे थिबे साउलो कलेक्शन करबो से पुजारी को दिया पड़बो तापर ए जो माने कुकुड़ा गुटे पुजवा पे थाकु पुजारी को दिया हेबो से जाई करी ना कि भाड़ रे ओंडी थिबे ना कि ओंडी रे जाई करी से पूजा करबो सर
नाइक के करिया बोले के आगर कहबो
नाइक
नाइक कहबो
नाइक कहबो
नाइक एंड
बोले सलाम को पसारबे
नाइक एंड सलाम एंड दे विल डिसाइड द व्हेन द
बिफोर स्टार्टिंग एनी म्यूजिक और डांसिंग प्रोग्राम्स फर्स्ट दे विल वार्म अप warm up the drums with the heat, which you can see here. They are warming up their drums, warming up the drums, because now it is giving the sound is dum 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 dum. Once it's got heated up, then it will give the sound. This side you can see here, dup dup dup. This side is warmed up like this. It will so all the equipments they will be warmed up, then they will go for the actual dancing and music play. They will be commencing with the heating of these equipments. So now we are going to have the Kartik, that is a hunting and gathering festival, Chaita Parva dance and song. These are the peacock feathers. You can see here the beautifully decorated with the traditional beads and dress. The ornaments you can see here, they are decorated, and they are going to have the Chaitra Parva dance and song. Yes. Thank you.
Festival for God, thanksgiving for the God for giving them for the good crops and harvesting. Here you can observe here. There are three groups, 1, 2, and 3. All the three groups are singing differently. That is the uniqueness of this song, this dance. Over? Yeah. Pusar Kisam, they will call in their own language, Bodo language. Now we are going to have that dance and the song. Let us have it. Okay? Here you can see the bow and arrow and also the agriculture implement he is keeping. They are giving the thanks to the God for giving them the good harvesting. Here the two girls are responding for their songs which they are singing.
Oh,
happiness song sung by the exclusively by the ladies. This is on happy occasions they will be singing this song.
मर बाय बाय बसर बाय बाय सर ओडसाडे माना मैं पजू लोकड़ फिर रहे पे बन पाए अपे ओडसा
The male songs are sung for the happy occasions. Exclusively the male people will be singing the songs. We are going to have a song mixed with both male and female. This will be a very interesting song. Generally, on happy occasions, they will be singing these songs, both male and female. Let us have the song of Bodo. Both male and female folk. Yes.
Under the Bonda Micro Development Project and also Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, the government of Orissa and the central government established a Bondo educational complex. This is the Badeli, Kandaguda, Malkangiri district, the educational complex for the Bondo. It is functioning well. Around 250 students are studying in this hostel. They have a headmaster here and the good number of teachers and the hostel warden who takes care of the children. Here I have observed the school is functioning well. The children are happily living here and you can observe the environment is also good, but only thing is lacking is the playground. They have to play within the small space which is available. Here they have given, students are given good uniform. Let us look into the inside and outside the educational complex. They have a very good building and water storage tanks. Sanitation facility is good. Kitchen is also very good. And they are getting the fresh water, protected water for drinking and taking bath. This is a Bondo hostel where the girl children are getting education and also staying here, and no doubt they have been taken care of. And you can see the children, they are not malnourished when compared to the children who are living in the villages. No doubt this kind of development definitely develop the primitive tribes, and also they will bring name and fame to the nation. This kind of development is necessary from the education side.
We have two important persons among the Bodo primitive tribe here. Those who are national and international level sports persons. Here we have, this is Indrajit Kirsan, which we have here. He is expert national player in archery. And this side I am having Haldi Darpada Mahaji. He is a very important person. He has played saucer both national and international level. He has visited many countries also for playing the saucer. Now I request Amarjit Singh to Indrajit Singh to tell about himself.
मो ना होची इंद्रजित किरसानी ग्राम होची कुरीगुड़ा मु षष्ठ पढ़लाल को स्पोर्ट्स हॉस्टल रु जो कोच आउ मैनेजर माने आसिले से माने मते हाई स्कूल रु सिलेक्शन करनेले तापर जयपुर को नेकरी डिस्ट्रिक्ट सिलेक्शन करले डिस्ट्रिक्ट सिलेक्शन करिकरी भुवनेश्वर ट्रेनिंग देले ट्रेनिंग देकरी तापर स्पोर्ट्स हॉस्टल को सिलेक्शन करले स्पोर्ट्स हॉस्टल कोरापुट आसिले कोरापुट आसिकरी गोटे दि वर्ष रही ट्रेनिंग कले सी हॉस्टल थे प्रैक्टिस कले प्रैक्टिस कर पुणी मयूरभंज को पठाइले मयूरभंज पठाईकी तापर सी खेल जाइए कटक कटक रु पतिला जोटी हरियाणा से कहते सी जा
सौटा कंट्री रू मैंने बार पंद्रहटा कंट्री आमको खेल आरंभ होगा जो बड़े तो फास्ट आमको कहले तुम्हें इंडिया जाऊ मैंने जीतिक जीव ना हारिक जीव आम कहलु आम साहस सहित जो कहल आम जीतिक जीव तापर से फास्ट मैच ये आरंभ जाम्बिया रो इंडिया रो फास्ट मैच टा जेंते फास्ट हेलो तापर जीती गलो पर आउ नेक्स्ट मैच ब्रेक अप परे मैच टा आरंभ हेला रोमानिया सहित भी जीरो रे परास्त कलु तापर आसिला जाम्बिया ए रोमानिया सहित भी सेमती जीरो रे परास्त कलु जीरो रे परास्त कला परे आउ दुईटा मैच हेला तापर मोर हाथ एंजड़ गला सेथिरे मते हाथ एंजड़ कि सब मैच खेलु छुकुरवा दिन तापर फाइनल मैच टा साउथ आफ्रिका सहित फड़ीतिले तापर फाइनाल मैच तारे जिते बड़े तो इंडिया आउ साउथ आफ्रिका प्रेजेंट कलु तो सेते बड़े कहउछन्ति जितिबा ना हारिबा सेते
बड़े सो दिस इज द मसल फॉर ए प्लेयर यू कैन सी हियर दिस मसल इज वेरी स्ट्रांग फॉर दिस पीपल एस्पेशली अमंग दिस पीपल दिस आर आल्सो स्ट्रांग अमंग द निकोबारी ट्राइब आल्सो वेयर द बाइसिकल दिस ईयर द थाई बोन इज आल्सो दिस मसल इज आल्सो वेरी स्ट्रांग कंपेयर टू अदर पॉपुलेशंस सो दिस इज द वन ऑफ द इंपॉर्टेंट physical characteristics for the football or cycling, running, you know, also these muscles plays a important role, and these knees joints and very strong joints are they have by birth is a one of the genetical characteristics in this population, especially among the aborigines. So we have to select these aborigines identifying to play in the Olympics, national and international games, then only we will be able to successful. We have many tribal such a type of people in India, but we are not able to do it in a proper way. That is the important one. Here you can see his muscles, archery muscles. You can see here, without any efforts, his archery muscles and the eyes. You can see here how sharp he is the eyes. That is very important for them aiming the target and throwing the arrow is biologically, genetically inbuilt character for them, because they have the arrow and arrows from generations. They are doing this bow and arrow using. So that is what which I suggest we can identify some of the aborigines in India, especially what the games they play, and we can promote them so they can win the games not only in the national level at international level and Olympics. I am requesting him to make an aim for this plant. So you can aim any place, he will shoot. Here you can see here, he has shot at the arrow. I have aimed the place, he has shot at the arrow. Now again you can make it here. Yes, he has done it. So that is the indigenous characteristics of these aborigines. So such a type of people we have to promote to participate in the Olympics and national level games. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Sharing that in the head now.
Major part of the subsistence economy of Bonda is taken care by the Bonda women. Here, let us find out what are the issues are related with the health and economy.
The mud dust is entering the where they are doing
agriculture.
Agriculture.
Yes.
This problem of ice.
Ice problem. They have plenty of them are having the ice problems here. I have observed. Ophthalmology problem is there. For many of them are suffering with eyes problem. Yes.
Jungle product la dele. Jor.
Khuli ga na khotre le dabu bedar chal.
Khuli hui na dabu abe to khotre. Pehle काम सर कष्ट मस्त रहते काम देती नहीं बुरे करिंगो थगा मारे गुरु सब सुगुरु खटरेस ले उसमें बैठो उतारी सेगा उला ओई सेगा ले ओई सेगा कष्ट मस्त रहते बुटी मोर सिपलाई रुक करे सिपलाई नहीं हुई थी नहीं उसी को स्टोर ऐसे गने बंदा ले ब्लॉक करने काम ही ना बस दागो अब तक कर रहे उस मरे तो कस्टम स्टोर ऐसे गा वाव इतने ये बस दागो उस लोग बाबे तो आने बेकार है काम ले बस गा कर रहे उस मरे तो अने दागो अब तक मार अब तक उला ओई ना ले ओई ना थारी ना दागो बागना बती मर्सी रुक करे सुनते नहीं किरिंग अब
ना किरिंग अब तो they will be taking the half rate, but the actual rate.
Oh.
And sometimes they will eating that forest root, some roots are they collecting and eating, and sometimes they will sleeping in empty stomach.
So that is the food is the one of the major problem, and marketing is another major problem they are facing. Yeah, this is the important one issues the woman is raising. Well, woman is the, generally they will go for market, sell their forest produce or minor forest produce, whatever it is. So they are facing the problem in selling the produce. When they go for the market, they are not even getting the half of the price of the product. That is one of the important one. And another thing is, you know, they have the food problem. That is the food problem that we have already explained to the people of India, that these people should be taken care of from the hunger and the starving.
And another thing is, so they want the separate market complex for them, said that this...
They want a separate market for the bond people to sell their products. She is given a very good valid points. I hope that I will take this message to the higher authorities, to the policy makers.
Fresh water is one of the major problems, not only for the Bondo tribe, but also many of the tribes who are inhabiting in India. Here you can observe that Bondo has to go long distances for collecting the water for the drinking purposes. Even from children to elder women, the usual practice is to go for water fetching in the early morning itself. Here we can observe she is collecting the water from the spring water. Most of the tribes in India, they are depending on till to date on the spring water, stream water, river water. Here she is collecting the water from the spring water which is coming from the paddy fields. See how she is carefully she is collecting.
She is collecting the water from this.
This water they will be using for drinking and also for cooking purpose. So these springs, they will be worshipping annually also. And we have going to have a dance festival worshipping of these springs. So they will consider this as a sacred place. Not only the agriculture fields, that is Mother Earth, they will be worshipping. They are also worshipping these springs. Here you can see she has collected the water and taking the water to the house. So it is generally done by the women only. It takes long time for water fetching itself. So during summer seasons, the springs will dry. Then they had to go miles together to the get the river water. That is one of the major problem, not only the Bondo, but also almost all the tribals are facing in India.
Primitive tribes are vulnerable population in India. Among the 75 primitive tribes in India, this is one of the tribal population who is fighting for their survival. Here we can see the Bondo population in Bondo Hills region which we have visited. You can see most of the people are below poverty line and they have the problem of survival. Here you can see these people, most of them are malnourished, both infants, mothers and breastfeeding mothers also they are having the problem of malnourishment. Here in this region they need a special unique project. A action plan should be prepared for conservation of these people. Like in Andaman tribes, these people also facing a threat for their survival. We have very few villages. Total number of villages is 31 villages.
In all the villages, there is a problem of education, which you can observe here in this village. Many of them are not able to go for school. You can observe here these children who are malnourished and not able to go for the school because the school is away more than 5 kilometers from their settlement. So it is necessary that every village should be provided a school in this tribal region.
So educational institution which they are provided by the micro project is not sufficient to have all the accommodate all the students. That is why I suggest they need a 4 or 5 schools, like a micro project model schools, multiple schools, which can able to accommodate all the children for their education. That is very important, and the school should be within the reach of their hamlets. Thing is, the health problems, most of them are all the Bodo tribes, still they are depending on the indigenous medicine, which is still age-old practice they are practicing. No medical doctor or health camp is conducted here. Only for namesake, the medical doctor and camp is conducted here. There is a need for a medical camp weekly once to come here to see the see all the people, how ill health they are. They are not at all health. Many of them are suffering with the eye problems. You can see here, she is suffering with eye problems. She is malnourished. She is very weak. And you see the conditions of their living. It is really a pathetic conditions. It is worse than Andaman Island tribes. I request that they should be provided nutritional food like ANMS, that is, you know, Anganwadi workers, which you are providing. You can see here all the children, malnourished children, infants, pregnant ladies, mothers. They should be given daily food in the morning for the to get good nutritional status. That is very important, one which I wanted to suggest in connected with the health. Then you can come to the economic aspect of this Bodo tribe. They have struggling very hard for their existence itself. Still they are practicing the Bodo cultivation, food gathering and hunting. Very few of them are having the agriculture. That is, you know, minor 5% of them are having. Very few growing turmeric and banana and different type of fruits and vegetables. This is not sufficient for them for their livelihood, as it is a unique tribal population struggling hard for their survival in India. I hope this is the one of the tribe like Andaman tribes facing the threat for their existence. If you are not going to take up the action plan and for saving these people may extinct in another 2 decades. That is my, as anthropologist, I feel myself. Then coming to the welfare measures, the government has taken up several schemes, several actions for this development. In spite of it, they are not able to develop because of the several problems they are facing is water problem, health problem, and educational problem, and also the welfare measurements. So I request that an action plan should be prepared for separately for these people, and there should be a separate unique project for these people to be prepared, and we have to save these people. Otherwise, this rich wealth of our nation, this is the rich wealth of our nation, they are going to extinct from the planet. I request the policymakers, administrators, bureaucrats and the researchers to come in a big way to help these people. Otherwise, they will extinct from the planet. This is my appeal to all of you, those who are viewing, or also to the policymakers and also the political leaders. Thank you very much.
The Bonda are an unique population living on the earth. The Bonda are biologically, genetically, culturally a distinct population. The Bonda are living in isolation for ages. The cultural heritage which you have seen is very important for us to preserve. It is the duty of every citizen of India to save these vulnerable population before they extinct from the planet. In this occasion, I would like to thank my research scholar, Mr. Gangadhar Huala, who helped me in documenting the film, and also the cameraman who is working with me, Mr. Anand Jyoti, for his help. Finally, I thank all the Bondo people who helped me in filming this document to dedicate the film to the nation.